I'm glad you're here.
Thank you very much.
And that posted Sunday.
You'll be seeing this on Focus on Facade for sure. But it's on About Facade. Nidia runs the web blog About Facade.
Hi.
You can come sign in on the machine if you like.
And who are you with?
Hey, Nidia.
Thanks for coming. It's good to see you.
Been a while.
You doing?
Fine. Now, who do you work with?
Emery.
Yeah. He used to be my brother-in-law.
Jody Moses?
Uh-huh.
Okay, nice to meet you. I've met your daughter.
Yeah, she's eight.
Yeah.
Now Lindsay.
Baby boy.
But yeah, he's been hanging a long time.
How are you? I work for Emery. We're also very good family friends, too, so I see a lot of the family.
Oh, really?
I've seen your daughter many times.
Yeah. In graduate school, but did you know Jim? Oh gosh, I can't believe it. He was the big real estate guy in town for years and years. He was a friend of mine, but we bought his little house. I've known Emery since I was in dental school. But I'm out now.
Yeah. I even know Ruthie.
You know Ruthie?
Absolutely.
Oh, Lordy.
Thank you.
I tell you, Ruthie's a sweet little person.
Okay. Sure. No problem.
David,
I thought that was you driving by. So how you doing? Where are you going?
This is the old plan that the old
You can just take a moment and sign in. Have you been here?
106 acres, because they also had part of the killing. But this has the waterways clearly on it. So this was the 2006 or 2005 plan. But see, look, he's got stream buffer right here. He's got floodplain here. Okay, this is Dave's Creek. He went around.
Where's Vicky?
Vicky's right here. And see, he had this part of Vicky also. All this is 106. This is Bennington.
So we have a creek here.
Yeah. So this is Bennington right here. Okay. So we got a creek tributary right here that he was having to work
around. You'd like
around.
To sign in?
We've got one here.
Sure.
Thank you
And we've
very
got
much.
A floodplain. And I want to make sure that the people who understand the water, that his site, I don't think his site
is as buildable as you might think.
Got it? Thank you.
All right, well then, Lydia's got it.
Oh, Lord,
Nice to meet you.
Anyway,
participation meeting. This is not the public hearing for this. That will come on later at the county administration building. But the purpose of this meeting is to discuss with you the Res 6 zoning, which we're proposing on Babes Creek Drive. This is on 83 acres of land there on the north side. Yes.
Would you please introduce yourself?
Yes, I'm Emory Lipscomb. I beg your pardon. I'm sorry.
Everybody was talking and we couldn't hear.
I'm very sorry. I'm Emory Lipscomb. I'm an attorney incoming, and I represent the folks who have filed for this rezoning of the property to a Res 6 zoning district. The proposal is to develop this with attached and detached residential units for sale, not for rent. These are not apartments for rent that we're proposing here. Brett Clark is the developer for this property. He is familiar with developing the product, which is shown here, that is expected to be built on this property, and that's been built over in Swan. So with that, I'll let Brett explain to you what we're proposing. We do have for you to take a look at an example of similar uses, both at the Lafarge Quarry, which is no longer Lafarge as I understand it, but that's what we call the quarry, which is adjoining three sides of this property, and the Martin Marietta Quarry, which is located down off of Georgia 141, where there are similar products, similar densities to what we're proposing here. Thank you.
Thanks, folks, for being here this evening. My name is Brett Clark. I'm here as a developer. As you can see, Emory's put some boards up here, the two different quarries here. Our site being almost encapsulated by the quarry, and I think you said it was sold, is that right?
Yes.
Here it is, right here, anybody wants to see. We got the rock quarry wrapping us on three sides here. We feel like, given this location, these unique circumstances, that this type of product is warranted. We've got the site laid out 378 townhome units, fee simple, attached product. We're looking into some detached product along Dave's Creek Drive, and we're probably going to add a second entrance on Dave's Creek just because of the number of units. And I've put up here, if anybody wants to pass them around, pictures of some townhomes. And this was shot today, if y'all want to pass these around.
How are you going to get off Dave's Creek?
Well,
Emory
can speak to the Oklahoma road widening project. I don't know exactly. You might want to update them.
I don't have the dates of the plans for that. No, sir. I don't.
There's no way to get off of it.
I'm sorry.
There's no way to get off of it. We're screwing up everything.
It's a difficult. I mean, it's a very small move to have that many cars.
Let me just tell you, I've invested my fortune in land and living here because of the way it is. And I'm just going to go ahead and let you up front. I'm going to fight you in every way possible. No,
I appreciate your opinion.
How many people are for this high density? How many are against this high density? I mean,
this will not happen.
Yeah, I mean, there you go.
Appreciate
you. We would ask you to wait and let us get through this presentation, and then we'll be glad to answer any questions anyone has. Thank you.
I'll make it brief.
Quick question for Brett.
Yes.
Are you the same developer that tried to put this thing in a couple of years back?
No. Okay. No, that was David Moss, and he's no longer here.
David Moss didn't try to put that in.
David Moss
did not try to put something like that in.
David Moss had the property in the contract.
He had,
we know.
This is 83 acres. David had 106, and he was trying to put 209 units on 106, and this is 378 acres on 87 units on
88.
These are 378 single townhomes, fee simple ownership. They're not rentals. They're not apartments. They're not anything like that. We've got a quarry that, as y'all know, wraps us on three sides, and just from a pure land planning, this makes sense.
Excuse me, does the quarry wrap you on three
yes,
sides?
Yes, it does.
The actual quarry itself is beyond that, but the actual digging space is just to your west and to the east. Can I ask a question? Is this...
Before is...
We get through with our presentation and then we...
I'll answer all those questions.
He answered a question over there. I thought he might answer if he was associated with that HUD project that y'all tried to put in.
No, we don't build apartments. We don't build HUD. We don't.
Okay.
I invite any and all of you guys to go look at what we build. Go to Swanee Town Center to the left and see. I'm passing pictures around of what we build. This is what we have planned for this site.
Well, actually, it's totally irrelevant what you build somewhere else, really, isn't it?
It's 10 minutes from the site.
Yeah, but it's still totally irrelevant if you build at different quarries, similar, whatever. We are talking about the Cumming Quarry, the Aix-la-Farge Quarry, where you are going to put 6 units per acre, which is going to be, looking at this, they're cheap homes.
They're not cheap homes.
Well, how much are you going to sell them for?
High twos.
That's I beg your pardon?
High 200.
Oh, really?
That's not a cheap home.
Who is going to buy in a residential area with 6 units per acre? Who is going to pay your high twos?
We had a ton of sales at our Swanee.
Are you going to tell these people as well that as soon as the quarry starts blasting, their foundations are going to move, their tiles are going to break? Are you going to do that?
Yes. We put people on notice all the time. If there's chicken houses next door, we put them on notice. If there's chicken houses next door, yes.
How will you put them on notice?
It's in the covenants. It's in our sales center.
Would you agree to a single one-page disclosure that's signed by the individual that's titled quarry adjacent
yes.
groundwell shape?
That's
all I need to hear.
Tile damage and so on and so forth. Structural damage to your homes.
You agree to a one-page document of disclosure. That's good enough for me.
All right.
We don't want that there. It doesn't matter if it's good.
I guess I can cut it short. We can fill questions. That way I don't have to be here all evening. If y'all want to start asking questions.
Well, I don't think there's any amount of explaining of this that you can do that's going to make the people who have already lived here and are here before you and built this type of land and want to live in this type of area where this is agriculture and you're trying to take it so far res six. I worked over by Swanee Town Center. That's 4-lane highways, PIB.
Yep.
That's other access. That's yep. that's retail market. That is not a rural small street coming out of Windermere Golf Community with a hairpin center small. A small school that's already set, got 30 students to one in there. I mean, you are literally destroying what I have built to live here for many years.
Not only about you, but you have to build that for many years. No other people as well.
That's not why I moved here.
You know when you move into the fastest growing county in the U.S. that you're going to see growth.
That's why I specifically picked a place with agricultural and all this stuff that's by this so that nobody can come in and drop junk.
That's not reality. We've all seen stuff develop around us.
I don't think this has ever been done. Like,
why won't you build with lower density? It's good enough for Ryland Homes that's immediately adjacent at 1.9 units per acre. Most of the surrounding area that's on this side along Davis Creek is low to medium density. Mo lives in a neighborhood of 3 to 5 acre estate homes. State Representative Jeff Duncan lives in a $3.25 million neighborhood in Cascading Creek. It's adjacent to the quarry. So this notion that the quarry is somehow tainted or not good to be against, that just doesn't shake out. Now, if you're on the side where the Georgia 400 is, yeah, that might make sense. Go put this up there, and we won't bother you.
I live off of Picky Lane. I'll have to overlook this. That was a $1.4 million house.
Yeah.
5 acres.
Yeah,
so
why won't you build something else that's less density?
Because we want to do something quality. We think that having townhomes in this setting is... I don't think I can sell a $500,000 home next to the
quarry. Ryland Homes told me this week that they would like to buy this property to continue the 1.9 density. Did you hear that? Bill Toll with Ryland Homes told me this week that he would like to buy this property or any property across the street.
I'm sure they're buying up everything.
To continue, but they want to build at 1.9 density, sir. You want to build it. And the reality is the density you talk about that Gabrielle mentioned, when you put in your buffers, your roads, your detention ponds, you're actually about 8 or 9 units per acre.
I'm at 4.5 units. My plan's 4.5 units per acre.
Not even the commission that's already reviewed it thinks you're there. They want you to rewrite the thing because I said there's no way you're at 4.5.
Yes, it is. You can do the math. It's 84 acres. It's some math.
How would your why not with the buffer that they talk about being 50 instead of 25? No, there's no difference.
It's 4.5 units per acre is what is So 378 lots on 83.6 acres.
Six units per acre right on your map.
Res 6, that's the zoning designation.
And the 4.5, that doesn't include all the access roads, all the...
No, that's how they calculate density in Forsyth. Yeah, that's how they calculate
density. So that's not reality.
Who's that?
Forsyth County Planning Department.
Okay, so us, we kind of do 8 or 9 units per acre.
I don't know how you get there.
Yeah, so this doesn't fit into the future planning of Forsyth County at all.
Did have another question?
What is the process that you're having to go through to change it from agricultural to res 6?
This is the process.
Where does it go from?
The planning commission.
Okay.
And that goes to the board commission.
So we go to the Forsyth County.
And also, no, you go to the commissioners.
The planning commission is actually the one that's attached.
So you're looking at just the ones on the bottom level?
See, just there's three.
You're going to build all of those?
No, just the ones on the bottom.
These are
no, right. No. Combination.
The bottom.
These are the townhomes attached. These are the detached townhomes. Same product. Just there's 10 feet between.
How many feet?
And after the first turnover, then we get not only the traffic, but then we add to it the crime and the safety issue.
Right. And then it's a school issue. We have to build a whole new school to be able to have the school where
Dave's Creek is already open.
We have to go there.
Well, not only that, but what about the traffic? Dave's Creek can't take, so they make, Dave's Creek four.
Right
four
yeah. Say a bunch
so
of
they make
yes, ma'am.
Creek four lanes.
The entrance you have on Dave's Creek, there's just one entrance on.
Right now.
There's one entrance on Dave's Creek.
Yeah. Right now, yes.
And that's, you know, that's a two-lane road, right?
Yes.
Okay, and there's going to be 600 cars coming out of this unit onto a two-lane road onto Dave's Creek.
So you're going to get sued 600 times for the accidents that happened right here.
Well,
and I'm going to have my brother.
South County. That's what their responsibility.
Are you going to put a stoplight or anything there?
If it wants to, yes, you can put a stoplight in. You know?
How can anybody want this on Forsyth County?
The engineering department is going to have to dictate what we have to do as far as left turn lanes, road widening, center turn
road,
lanes.
At 8 o'clock in the morning, that road is so backed up already past that entrance. No one's going to let those people out. I mean, I'm not going to have to sit all the way back into Windermere to get down that road. That's ridiculous.
Whatever
like,
they
all I did was buy the damn land.
whatever they make us do, I mean, we're going to have to do it. I mean, when we design developers, they say...
Will you expand the road?
We may have to. I don't know. We haven't gotten the technical review from it because we don't have a set of plans ready to submit. You know, the process is go through the zoning process and then we submit plans.
We should quit. Unless he has $10 million to spend on legal fees, he should quit. That's how much we'll make it spend.
So, I mean, clearly everybody in the room is saying it doesn't make any sense to have one entrance. So, if you're looking at this and you see that there's only one entrance and there's over, what do we say, 600 people that are going to be there.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you don't have to be a developer or a rocket scientist to think that that's a bad idea. So at what point in your plan does this turn into something that's actually going to occur?
When we get a little further in the process,
when they get
like I just explained to her. From the when we get comments back, when we get through the zone and we get go for plan submittal, we get comments back from the engineering department.
So
they're going to set they're going to dictate what road improvements get done, whether it's a traffic light, center turn lane, the left turn lane, to provide stacking out here on Dave's Creek. That's all dictated to the engineers.
No, that's not why we moved here. That's not in the future development.
I've actually lived there all my life, and I've been through all these questions with every development that's been in there. I mean, you know, I'm okay with it. I mean, I'm not opposing or for it at this time, but we own all the property across the road from that.
Mm-hmm.
How many detached and undetached are you going to have? And on the attached, how many are you going to have together? Is there going to be 5, 7?
6, I think.
6.
Just consider 6 families per acre.
Well, I mean, I'm like I just said, I was saying the same thing when other people moved in on Vicky Lane, Windermere, everything else. I've lived there all my life.
Nothing like this.
Most of all that property at one time was owned by my family. So, I mean, I've been here and I've seen progress and it's continuing on and it's probably gonna continue. But everybody wants the best they can get for the community, yeah. And that's why I was asking the question.
Well, there's a subdivision being put on right across the street.
Joins my property all the way down there.
Yeah, so we got not only the 367.
But I hope to sell mine one day to somebody to build another.
The only difference is that your property is going to be
I didn't really know what we're building.
Nice houses, all of them are going to be detached.
Yes, sir. Is it correct that you're only talking about one entrance on Dave's Creek?
Yeah. Right now, our preliminary was just one.
Is there any other entrance?
We've got room to put a secondary entrance on there. We're just
question.
But they're all from your experience,
probably have to have a second entrance.
But my question is, from your experience with this number of units, what is the average number of cars that will increase?
It depends on. It really just depends on the
1.5 or 2.
Probably somewhere between 1 and 2 cars. I mean, some folks have been in, they're single moms, they're widowers, they just got one car, some folks have been in. 2 is the upper end of it.
What is the adjoining properties, what is going to be put between your property and their property? My mother's going to have 15 homes overlooking her house.
There's a creek between us and the other properties.
Not all of it.
Not all of it.
Okay. My mother lives downhill, and her home is about 20 feet from your property line. Okay. Where's all that water going to go? They're going to go in there and level all of the trees. Okay. And all that water is going to come down, and all that mud is going to come down to her driveway.
I hope not. I would hate something like that.
I'm just telling you, nature. It will do it. There's a rut there already in her yard. And nothing's been moved. Nothing's been moved, and there's already a rut in her yard.
It starts on the other property.
Does your property connect to Old Atlantic at all?
No. There's a commercial piece and a DOT right away and a M1 zone between us and Old Atlantic.
Where would the second entrance exit be?
It would be on that street.
Hey man, after you get done with this, I might put a 34 skyscraper in my backyard. It's about the right same amount of zone.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, I have my paper with me. I can't find it, but I did look through the county papers and I see where the engineering waived. You have to do a traffic study.
Yeah, prior to the zone submittal, we were required to do one, but we'll have to do one before.
Well, see, I don't understand the process. So would they have you do one or not?
Yes.
Okay.
Wow, we've had them on 60 lots, so it just depends on the traffic counts, existing traffic counts. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah,
they
do have it. There's an 80-foot right away there. We'll cross them.
You're going to build houses right over
there? No, our street will cross. No, we're not building on top of it. We can't do that.
So we need a traffic reduction of 3,610
yes, ma'am.
Average day.
What is this going to do to the poor schools? We can't hear what you're saying, ma'am.
You had two children to a house. What are you going to do with the schools when you got that many children?
We're sharing in the tax base.
That's got nothing to do with that part.
It doesn't have anything to do with the school.
No, it's not
it makes
problem.
Up about 70% of my tax.
You've got two or maybe three children to a house, and there's 300 and something. The schools can't accommodate things like that.
It wouldn't matter if it was 10 neighborhoods of 30 houses. It's still the same impact on the school system.
It would, depending on the location.
Correct. If they're all in the same school district. Yes.
Is this zoned for Dave's Creek schools? Is this Dave's Creek Elementary?
Is that right?
Yes, Dave's Creek.
Yes,
how many attached and how many unattached units are you planning on building?
Probably about 70% will be attached and 30% will be detached product.
So there's
two price points.
There's a few token unattached houses to make it seem like
no, there's two products, two price points.
What's the lowest price?
That's a change of use.
Mid to high twos. Probably low threes in the detached stuff.
What's your fixture?
About 70% attached and 30% detached. Yes, ma'am.
What are the square footages going to average?
Our attached products, they're ranging from 1,900 to 2,200 square feet. Our detached is about 2,200 to 2,800 square feet.
This is only attached?
Detached and attached.
Attached
first and then detached was.
How many detached and how many attached units had you built?
70-30. She just said attached.
70 what?
70 attached.
70% attached, 30% detached.
Okay. Emory, can you speak to what's going to happen with the quarry as far as being a reservoir in the future?
I don't have any information about that. I don't know. It's my understanding that LaFarge has sold its interest in the operation of the quarry, and I don't represent the quarry or the owner of the land. So I don't know. I know there have been discussions about that, but I don't know where those are.
Because that will affect way down the road. That might have some effects.
It's important, I think, for our elected officials to know how you feel out here tonight. We have a planning commissioner, Dr. Joe Moses, here. In the back of the room, you have Jamie Iglesias, Brian Thames, newly appointed commissioner, Todd Levent, commissioner, came out this evening. But if you don't let them know how you feel, then how can they react? So I'm going to raise my hand and say, I'm not in favor of this. Does anybody else agree with me that's not in favor of this?
You want to be reelected?
Hey, keep your hands up and let me take a picture, and I'll post this online.
This will be a nice thing. Donate call heavily to the reelections of the various.
You want a job in 2 years?
Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it.
You mentioned,
this is how the neighbors feel.
You mentioned the similarity to Suwanee Town Center. Do you see any similarity to Dave's Creek Road or Drive and Suwanee Town Center?
The problem.
I beg your pardon?
The product's going to be the same.
That has no bearing whatsoever.
It's the moon.
Yes, ma'am.
Except that Suwanee Town Center is also set up on a heavier intersection with live, work, play. Because there are shops in there, there are restaurants, there are businesses.
So this is
different. You're not building that. You're just building high density.
Yeah, it takes probably just as much time to get out on Marshall Swanee Road and Buford Highway as it does Dave's Creek.
But
it's
our time.
You go down there and try it on the road.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
Well, I introduced myself before. I'm president of Newgate in Windermere, Townsend. Mm-hmm. I suggest that if you're going to build townhomes, take a look at those.
Yeah.
That is your town. Mm-hmm. If you're going to build next to Windermere, you ain't going to build anything less than Windermere. Okay. Right. Starting with that, you're going to have to change your density, no question about it. And your connection to the townhomes is too many. This is not understanding drainage, utilities, access, all that other stuff. I mean, I talked about before you even get there. This is clutter. Okay, I suggest you clean that up and then try and present it again. But it's too dense and it's too junky.
Well, there is one other problem for all the people who live close to this so-called new development upmarket. And that problem is, as soon as they take down all the trees to build this, the noise buffer is gone for everybody. The noise buffer from these so-called townhomes, where you claim, oh, they all be privately owned. God only knows what riffraff is going to move in there. Do you understand that word?
Riffraff. People are going to buy them and rip them out.
Yes.
And not only that, but the quarry buffer is gone.
Yeah.
So as far as I can see, this is the most undesirable that I have seen from the three developers who wanted to develop something there. There was one developer who wanted to build a retirement homes for pensioners. No way. Just like yours. No way.
Yes, sir.
I live over in Woodland Park, and the noise and the explosions were so bad, they finally put a meter in my yard. If we was downstairs in that concrete basement, you could really get it. Now, I can imagine how long somebody's going to enjoy living where you're proposing. I'm also in Woodland Park where the traffic is so bad, morning and evening, you got to go the opposite way so you can get to where you want to go. And you're talking about dumping all that traffic. I seen the thing on Dave's Creek Road going into Brandon Road. Well, when you get to Brandon Road, where in the devil do you go?
Well, hopefully the road line and property will leave something.
The only thing, the only thing you're looking for is a book.
Brandon will always be a collector road. That's part of the transportation plan.
But that's really not true.
Was this also, was this kind of a plan on the future land use map that they had come up with? Because I looked on
future
future lot.
It's medium density there.
That's right.
And then the Dixieland is low density. Bennington's considered low. This is supposed to be medium density.
That's what I thought, because they didn't have anything like that showing on the map.
Well, there's two maps. There's the land use map and the future or the future development map. There's some.
It's hard to find.
And neither one of them have that on there, do they?
Medium.
Three houses.
No. Three.
Yes, sir. I mean, you've got your two pictures up here, adjacent zoning ranges, all that. That's very nice. We appreciate it. But if you look at the adjacent zoning ranges, the high density zoning ranges are zoned on Ronald Reagan, not on Dave's Creek, not on Old Atlanta. Ronald Reagan is a four-lane divided highway, limited access. That's why it's done that way, for high density and commercial development. Dave's Creek was never designed, neither was Old Atlanta designed to handle high density or commercial properties. And it's not going to happen in my lifetime.
Well, I agree. I agree that Old Atlanta needs it needs work.
There's a lot of property up there. It's just waiting on you to call.
To your point, sir, on the Forsyth County engineering maps, our infinite wisdom of our wizardry in the engineering department, if you go look at the map that the engineering department has, you could lay a straight edge ruler and you could see from one end of Dave's Creek to the other. But we all know that there was some on-site engineering and it made Dave's Creek more like this. It's not a straight road. So the engineering department, who bases their calculations on whether or not we should have additional cars out here, in their mind, they think it's a straight road.
It's not. When I take a ride on Vicky Lane, I look left, there's no cars. All of a sudden I take a right and someone's on my bumper. Because they come around a bend.
Emery just pointed out this one, that D.R. Horton's building off of Hall Creek Drive.
Oh my gosh, have you looked at that?
It's 4.98 units per acre.
That's no comparison at all. Oh, you go build your thing up there, we won't care.
It comes out on a two-lane street.
Do you see what you're abutting against?
So, do you have any opportunity for a separate right-of-way for a separate entrance? Because take the schools out, take all those kids out, take everything that's important and just put it to the back like you've already done, which is all those kids in those schools. So just imagine they're not there anymore. Is there any other opportunities for you to take traffic elsewhere?
Without going over the quarry, I don't.
Well, I recommend that you go and take some time and study that and then come back to us.
We've looked at it.
You didn't look hard enough.
There's enough room. You can go behind the church. You can go through where the former retirement center is and get some of Lewis Darnell's property. And then a little access that gets you up off somewhere off of Dave's Creek.
We've looked. Like I said, there's several parcels in between us. Actually, somebody mentioned the church, and the church has already signed an agreement. The intersection project is just waiting on the county. It's probably going to, if it's already not been put out to bid, it's probably going to be the next few days.
I don't think it's paid for many, many years.
It is going to be done within the next year. I can promise you. I've done signed the contract with them on the church property, and it will go out to bid. And the intersection on Davis Creek and Old Atlanta will be done probably this year.
How would it be done?
They bought all the property. and all the design work's done, I've got drawings on it.
Just like Gilbert, just like Gilbert Road is what they have planned, just like Gilbert.
It will not have a traffic light, but it does have.
Wider lanes and turn lanes, and that's it.
One what?
Well, and I'm not, like I said, I'm not speaking for or against right now, but I lived on Dave Creek Road. It hasn't changed when there were five houses there. And, you know, I've done been down this road with Windermere and everybody else, and I like Windermere. I've got nothing against it. But, you know, there is change, and that's why I'm here tonight to see what the change is going to be.
Well, there's also, you're already starting to build a community across the street. They're building a community across the street.
That's helpful, not harmful.
That's going to be nice.
And how many houses are in that unit?
60.
No, Seneca?
There's going to be 60 homes, and they're going to start at $400,000.
Very more.
Seneca?
Thank you for going through it. Is it possible to ask a question of the planning commission?
Here's somebody here that looking down.
Is that possible? Yeah, I was just wondering, is it possible to ask somebody who's here tonight for the planning commission a question? Is there somebody that would step up? I don't want to take it away from you, so that's okay. Is that something that could be asked? Because I'd like to know what the chances are of this happening. As it is there somebody who can speak to that?
I'm the district commissioner for that area. From what I'm hearing, no. But you have to, not this dense. I think this is too much density, unfortunately. I'm going to sit down with overlay maps. I'm going to look at everything that's in the area. I have to equate what's already there, find an average balance that's already zoned or already built. To me, that's how you find what the Georgia Constitution will or will not allow under land rights. Because I also have to vote according to the law. I can't just vote on emotions because then we get sued and we lose anyways. So the bottom line is there some Res 6 already approved on this property?
No.
It's agricultural. There is on the northeast corner of the same quarry.
Of the same corner.
That's Hawk Creek. That's Hawk Creek.
Which was under a retirement center.
Let me finish if you don't mind. There is a Res 6 that D.R. Horton is building on the northeast corner of this same rock quarry today.
Yes.
All of that. I'm not into all heavy density stuff. I personally live in a 1-acre lot, so if that helps you at all. However, the Georgia Constitution does speak to land rights, but it works both ways. It's a double-edged sword. It gives you some zoning, and it also keeps you from getting certain zoning because it infringes upon other people, like you all, in a lot of different ways. So the balance has to come in there, and I personally, I can't speak for anybody else, but when I do my vote, I look at all of it, and I try to find what's fair and balanced in the situation.
Does it matter whether we have the infrastructure to support this or not?
What infrastructure are you referring to?
The road, the sewer.
It does. No, it does. It absolutely does. All that is coming to my mind. I also look at, I understand what roads are pre-planned to be upgraded, including Old Atlanta. It is in this law, some which is about to start July of this year. So all of that, I look at everything. It's a lot to look at, a lot to consider when the decision comes in. Y'all asking for 5 point?
No, 4.5.
That's like statistics, mathematics. It's really 6. You're putting 30% in there to get it 4.5. So it's 5, 6. It's 6.
This property is on day one present, which is not a constitutional zoning.
We all trust.
There will be a zoning which will be allowed for this property.
There'll be some kind of zoning. My vote will be based on what I believe the state constitution would support. And if we didn't give it to them, if they were to file legal action against us, would they win or not? And that's where I try to find my balance. That makes sense.
Let me ask you a question. What do you intend to put around your development? Fence 20 feet high?
You're looking for sound buffer, correct?
Yes. Not only sound buffer. I don't want them people trapped on our property, and we enjoy it right there.
What makes you talking?
The ones you're selling. Oh, look, there are animals in the woods. Let's go and play in the woods there.
Pre-talking about.
the river. I'm talking about us. We have.
Now, which people are you referring to?
The people who are going to buy your homes.
Who are these people?
The people who are going to buy your homes.
What's wrong with them?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying, what do you put around it? David Moss was prepared to put a nice fence around this property. What?
What do you propose they put around?
Raise wire, a moat?
20 feet high fence.
It's going to back up the wood.
I don't care.
Call these people what you want to call them.
What do you intend to put anything around it?
I think what she's trying to say, I have woods and I have property subdivisions around us, and kids and people tend to think the woods are public parks, and they migrate and they come to play on your land and such. She has 5 acres bordering up to this, and that's it.
Six.
So if you've got people with kids and then let's go play in the woods, let's do our slingshot, and she doesn't want them going to her property, they're backing straight up to her. That's what she's asking.
On your property, we'll put a fence along your property. I have no problem with that. You're concerned about that.
I have a breeding kennel, and if people come on our property, they run the risk of getting injured. That means our insurance has to kick in if these people get injured, if these kids, whoever, wanders on the property. I'm not prepared to do that because we are liable then, except for the horses. If they get hit by the horse, too bad.
I think we all share that same liability as property owners here in America.
Well, actually we don't, because at the moment there is nobody there who wanders on our property uninvited.
Yeah, we're a couple of
them. I think we'd rather have the trees, frankly.
That's why it's my question. Are you intending to put a fence around it or what?
I don't plan on fencing the entire property and making it a compound, if that's what you're referring to. If you want a fence along our common property line, I'll be glad to accommodate you.
Look at Windermere.
Pardon?
Look at Windermere.
What about Windermere?
Windermere has fencing around it.
So you're back on
it?
No.
I like the note to keep
the neighbors off our property. Did I answer your question, ma'am?
No.
We'll do a common fence between me and you, so we don't.
I want to put you to see each other. We're not disturbing the stream.
We're not disturbing the stream. We're going to leave it as is. And then the stream wraps three sides of the property.
I have a question for Todd Levent and Mr. Lipscomb. You just told me you wrote this evaluation attachment to the county commissioners to have the property rezoned. And I can't read the whole thing, but in it here, you put that these homes will enhance the surrounding property value. That the area is already comprised of industrial, commercial, office, industrial, and single family subdivisions. And there are no commercial properties in this area whatsoever. And I don't know how you could put that in there as a reason why this rezoning should be allowed.
I agree with you that they're not retail type products there. They're industrial.
There's no industrial there. Around there.
There's an M2 property which joins this property, which is the heaviest industrial zoning that the county allows is the M2 zoning. There are very few M2 zone tracks, probably could count them on one hand, maybe two hands, certainly could. The mining zoning would certainly be as dense of a commercial or an industrial use. I'm sorry.
That's the quarry.
The rock quarry is 400 acres.
So basically, instead of just saying quarry,
you made it look special.
Well, the other thing, too, is that you stated in your report to Mr. Levent, the most reasonable use is for this. Yeah. So why cannot it stay agricultural and put in single home family homes?
Agricultural has been held to be an unconstitutional zoning district in Forsyth County. So it's not a constitutional zoning district. The people who own this property have a right to another zoning district.
Mm-hmm.
And we're saying to you that we think that the detached and attached townhome product
would be a constitutional zoning. I would respect y'all's rights your views that you've expressed here. Certainly, you're entitled to those views, and we respect it. And perhaps there'll be something that'll come out of this that will be somewhere in between.
Okay, and then explain one other thing, too. I'm like not trying to get everybody excited. That on the next page, you stated that if the commissioners do not read this and adhere to what you're advising, it's discrimination.
It would be per se unconstitutional if they don't grant a zoning other than the A1 zoning that the property property has. That's what we're saying. We're entitled to a constitutional zoning.
This isn't a linear golf situation that you guys are fearful about the Constitution. You can give them one unit per acre, and it's arguable that it would be constitutional. That's some fantasy and myth out there, and I think you could give them 1.9, just like they get across the street, and argue it long and hard in court.
Are your elected
officials willing to stand behind these citizens who overwhelmingly, almost 100% of them, said they don't like this?
Well, this is only a small portion.
We ain't through yet, are we? Focus on Forsyth. And if you go to Facebook and you search Focus on Forsyth, there are over 1,000 of your friends, families, and neighbors who are on that forum who have active engagements about these conversations here. So please go search Focus on Forsyth. There's also another website called aboutforsyth.com. aboutforsyth.com. Ms. Clisdale, who does a lot of the reporting of the antics of the government in our county, she's the one who's here this evening filming, and she has aboutforsyth.com. I encourage you to go there. Those are freedom of speech areas where you can go on there and communicate very freely with each other.
Is there any further questions? I got a wife and three kids at home. I'd like to see them before they go to bed. Any new questions? Anything that I haven't addressed?
Yeah, where do you live?
I live in Gainesville, on the Forsyth County side.
Okay, how many acres?
I live on a half acre lot.
Townhome?
No, nope, single family.
Single family, how big?
About 800 square feet.
Yeah. A big lot, yeah. Your television room, right?
Yeah. Is there any new questions?
What is the next step, though? I mean, we have a meeting tonight now.
The Planning Commission meeting is May 28th?
Fourth Tuesday of May.
Yes, sir.
You're getting these zoned as townhomes. Will you market and sell them as townhomes, or will you mislead the public and market and sell them as single family
townhomes? They are townhomes.
They're rental properties.
Yes, they are. Fee simple ownership properties that will be, if they choose to rent them, they're going to have to go against our covenants, and we can impose fines.
You won't know.
You're right. It is hard to enforce. I don't see somebody buying a $300,000 property, period.
People rent homes in Windermere, so it doesn't make any difference.
At this meeting, guys, we only get 10 minutes. You get 10 minutes at this commission meeting, we get 10 minutes. So if all of us stand up and say the same thing for 10 minutes, it's not going to work. No. So we need to get one voice, write everything down. Somebody needs to get up and speak for 10 minutes against this.
I have a question, though. When is that Planning Commission meeting?
Or Tuesday of May.
May 28th, I believe.
Addresses are online on the ForsythCo.com website. Send your commissioners, your county commissioners, emails with your concerns. Thank you.
Okay, the Planning Commission meeting is on May 20th, or what did you say?
28th.
On the 28th of May. Listen, guys, you better be there. Make sure that you go there.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Appreciate y'all's time. Thank you.
Thank you.
With the walk-through, I think everybody's
going to respond.
Now, we weren't supposed to get
Yeah, I mean,